أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته So my little heroes, hopefully you will be fine at home. May Allah bless you and keep you healthy at home. So how are you everybody? As you know that our second term online classes has been already started. But don't forget to prepare yourself for the first term exams as well. Today the date is 25th Jan 2021 and day is Monday. Let's start our science class. Before starting a new lecture, let's revise the previous video. What we have learned in the previous video, we have learned about Unit 8 Electric City. What we have learned in this lesson, we have learned who invented bulb. Do you remember? Yes, Thomas Alva Edison has invented bulb in 1879. And how does electricity produce? Very good. Through fossil fuels, through water generating system, through power stations, through dams. And who is the father of electricity? Do you remember that? I have told you. Yes. Michael Faraday is the father of electricity. And what are the uses of electricity? We have also learned that it is used in different electrical appliances, even in the factories and our houses, in our cities, even in modern era, electricity is our necessity. Okay, today we are going to continue this lesson. So let's start. Today I am going to tell you about what are batteries. Can you see the picture of this battery? A battery is a source of energy which provides a push, a voltage of energy to get the current flowing in an electric circuit. An electric bulb uses the electrical energy provided by the battery but doesn't use current. A battery has chemical inside it and is linked to a circuit. Then the chemicals inside the battery react together. This pushes a flow of electrons around the circuit. And the batteries and cells are used in remote controls, flashlights, toys, clocks, radios and calculators also. Some large batteries are used in automobiles. Batteries operated machines are much safer to use than those operated by mains electricity. Though you still need to be careful. Why? Because batteries contain chemicals and that could hurt you. So you should follow the safety rules while using the batteries. Now I am going to tell you about two types of batteries. Actually, batteries are commonly called cell as well. So cells are devices that add electrical potential energy to the charges moving through them. They do this using chemical reactions in their cells. There are two types of cells, primary and secondary. Or you can commonly call them chargeable and non-chargeable cells. Okay, non-chargeable cells, once the cell gives up all its energy, the chemicals cannot react again. You have to discard them. But rechargeable, once the cell gives up all its energy, the chemical reaction that causes it to lose energy can be reversed by a charger, giving it more energy to use in circuits. So how they are different? The difference between them is that rechargeable batteries can be put to use again after have been fully discharged once, while non-rechargeable batteries cannot be charged again once they discharge fully. For example, the batteries of your mobile is a great example of rechargeable batteries. You charge your mobile and it starts working again and again. But non-rechargeable batteries has to be discarded. They are not used again. Here comes one more picture. Can you recognize this picture? Very good. This is a kind of battery which you usually use for your remote control cars. For a remote control toys, and it is a rechargeable one. But few toys have the non-rechargeable batteries as well, like these, which are commonly called cells. Okay, hopefully you have learned a lot today about it. Read the chapter thoroughly and do question number 3 of page 62 on your book. What is that? You have to make a list of things that you can find in your home or school which use electricity. So stay safe, stay blessed. See you soon. Allah Hafiz.